What's up? What's up, y'all? What is up? What is up? This side of the side. What's going on, y'all? What's going on? We are back with another episode of Buzzing Indie Spotlight. As you come on in, go ahead and share this. I'm going to do likewise as well. I'm going to share this to a few people. As you guys come on in, just share it. We have a pretty good lineup of independent artists we're going to be chatting with this evening. Can't wait for you guys to get to meet them. Some of them you may already know, hear their stories, and just, you know, let's have an amazing time speaking and engaging with everyone tonight. Not going to spend a lot of time on what's happening. I know there's a lot of new music that is out right now. You guys can check the page, check one of our many playlists that we have out there. As far as upcoming events, Dolph Award is going to be going down. A lot of great events going to be happening around the Dolph Award. Shout out to Monarch. A lot of great events is going to be happening in and around the Dolph Award. So definitely, you got the basketball game that's happening, Urban Soul Cafe pre-Dolph event. It's also the official after party that's going to be going down, hosted by Root Magazine, Rich Gospel. Again, we've been posting about all of that. You guys go ahead, check those out if you're going to be out in that area. The only quick WWE SmackDown just came on, John Cena. What's happening, yo? He's so silly. Monarch family, what's happening? What's happening? Yes, so, and also too, it is also going to be in the New York area. So SOB's New York Soul Therapy Sunday on the 22nd. If you guys in the area, you want to check that out. Tasha Page Lockhart is going to be there. We're also going to have Molly Music, and Jules Judah is going to be premiering his release for his new album. So that's going to be going down. But without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and bring in the first person. Let me just go ahead and bring them in. And Danny, what's happening? Righting wrongs, what's happening, family? Letitia Montgomery, what's up? What's up? Let me go ahead and bring him in right now. Last night, we actually, while I'm doing that, we attended... My wife and I attended CeCe Winans' concert last night, and I must say that was quite amazing. Hey, Danny, what's happening? First time seeing CeCe live in concert, so, you know, we were out in Brooklyn, and man, that was... it was really interesting, because we showed up there, and shout out to the host, we showed up there, line was wrapped around the block. It was just super, super packed. By the time we got in there, we missed Todd as well as Jenna, but we barely caught, like, towards the ending of Todd's set when we were coming in, heard him kind of like wrapping up. But yeah, it was packed to get in the doors. But while we were there, saw everything with CeCe. Yeah, for real, Lo, CeCe's definitely amazing. So yeah, that was great. I know she was just at your event recently as well too, right? The event you had out in Nashville for Erica Campbell. Let's see if Renwick is here.
Yeah, she came to Erica Campbell listening party. Yes. First time here in CeCe was at the Stella Award. It was amazing. Yeah, definitely. Her concert was just, it's one of those times that you just don't even want to sit. You want to just stand the entire evening. It was pretty good. I want to bring in someone else. Desi, if you're there, I'm going to bring you in. While we're waiting to see if Renwick is gonna pop in, I'm gonna go down the list. Bring you in right now. Desi, what's happening, man? How are you?
Hey, man, I'm good. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, man, I'm hearing you. I'm hearing you clearly. I just want to make sure everything is good. Good night, everybody. What's up? Happy to be here.
Okay, see you. Renwick, hop in. I'll bring him in in a second. I know he was a little pressed. He's a little pressed with time. But before I bring him in, go ahead and just, you know, great to finally meet you. You know, go ahead and introduce yourself. to our audience and just let them know where you're joining us from?
All right. So my name is DC, stage name DC. It's pronounced DC like Washington, DC, but spelled D-I-S-I. I'm from Guyana, South America, and I'm 28 years old. I'm a husband. I love the Lord. I mentor the youth in my area, my community where I live. I'm a teacher. I teach at a high school in the community where I'm from. That's Skeldon Line Park, Riverton. Okay. If anybody here from Guyana, all the Barbies people stand up.
Never been to Barbies. Mostly Linden. Linden is kind of my stomping ground, but never been to Barbies. I always say I need to make it there. I just never made it. I have to do that.
You need to come. You come to Barbies, you feel like you're on the best side of Guyana. Trust me.
Okay. I'll take your word for it.
Yeah. So yeah, man. As I was saying, just introducing myself to the people. I see some Guyanese people in the comment section. I see the flags. Yeah, really love the Lord, really love music, passionate about it from a really young age. And my whole aim in terms of music and artistry, I just want to present Jesus in a way that young people understand that he's not just make-believe. He's not just something in a book. He's not just something that the older folks believe in because they have come to their end of life and they can't have any more fun. But he is larger than life itself. And so in every way possible, I try to minister, encourage, recommend, suggest Jesus as the way, the only way. And, you know, just build from there. Yeah.
No, that's amazing. And I think the reason why I even caught wind of some of your, you know, your music and such, which we're going to get into just now, was through Renwick. And I think, let me see if I can bring, yep, I'm going to bring him in as well, because he's going to drop after a minute or two, and we can continue talking. Let's give him a sec to join in. Renwick, I added you. Okay, here we go. What's happening, brother? How are you?
I'm good, man. I'm just soaking up everything DC said. I'm so proud of him.
So go ahead as well, too, before we jump back into DC. Go ahead, Renwick. Just introduce yourself to the people. I know you're no stranger to the platform, but I kind of want to, you know, bring you in so you can, you know, give the people an update. You know, I think the last time we spoke is when you just released the collaboration with Renee. So I wanted to kind of have you pop on real quick, kind of, you know, give the people a bit of an update. But before we kind of jump into your update, you know, some of the stuff that DC was mentioning just now, as far
Big
as
Monarch.
You know, some of the stuff DC was mentioning just now, as far as, you know, just presenting Christ, but also presenting it in a way that it's not an end of life option, right? It's not like, hey, you're, you know, towards the ending of your life, and, you know, you just feel as though you have nothing Amen. Else to live for, so let's go ahead and try Christ, right? It's definitely more than that, and I've seen the same thing from you. So just piggybacking on that, like, what's your thoughts on that statement?
Yeah, man. You know, Christ is real, and I think what God has graced us to do and anointed us to do is to be a reflection of him, not just in the way that we live, but in our artistry. Because what God made grace us to do is to put a sermon on a beat or with music that will reach a generation or not even a generation, but just a specific type of people that God may have called you to, right? So we all have an assignment. And we all have these unique gifts and talents that we should embrace, because we all have a specific harvest that God has called us to and anointed us to reach. So that's our core goal, that the message of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ be heard in our music and be experienced, because it's one thing for people to hear the message of Christ in your music, So for me, one thing I always strive to do is not just to write songs from a biblical place, but also that the presence of God be on the record, so that when someone listens to that, The Bible says that if he be lifted up, then he'll draw all men unto himself. So the core of what we should do is always strive to lift up Christ in our music, in our artistry, and to also do it in excellence. And to also do it in excellence. Amen?
No, I love that. DC, speaking of music, you have a single that is out right now. Give us the name of that single and kind of the inspiration behind that single when you were creating that.
All right, so the latest single that just released was called Love God Like. And so, like, for me, we're Caribbean people, and everywhere we turn, it's dance hall music. Dance hall music runs it in Caribbean. I mean, we had a whole bit of debate as to whether Guyana was
Caribbean. I was going to say that. I was trying not to be petty. Let's keep going. I'm not even going to get into it. I'm not even going to touch that.
But Guyana being influenced by Caribbean culture, having Caribbean culture, dancehall is something that we hear a lot. And I find that the young people gravitate to the music in such a way, a manner, a depth that it influences their life choices and their life decisions. So for me, that song was a statement that, listen, the same way how your favorite dancehall artist loves their vices, loves the things that takes them through the day, whether it be weed, whether it be guns, whether it be alcohol, whether it be drugs, whether it be women, whatever it is that they love, that, listen, I love God to that extent and even more. And so, like, that's just a statement, like an anthem in itself, that, listen, I love God like how your favorite artist loves that thing that takes them through the night. Like, I rely on God. I yearn for him. I declare him. I big him up. I let people know about him the same way they are going to, you know, put it on their records and glorify it. That's the same way I want to glorify God, just in my life and the way I do things, and just so that people could know without a shadow of a doubt that, listen, I rep the king, I rep the kingdom. I have no reservations about it. I'm not gonna shy away from speaking about Jesus. If I can, I will, and I must, because it's really the way I have to live. Yeah.
But even talk a little bit about that, right? Because Renwick, even in your stance as well, right? When you first started releasing music with your boldness and so forth, like, at first it was just like, you know, you're still trying to figure out, you know, hey, this is the direction I'm gonna go in, but I'm also gonna be bold about it. I think that was one thing that everyone just seen, you know, off the cuff, is that this guy is unapologetically sold out for Christ and this is what he wants to do. But it took some time to get there, right? So you don't just get up tomorrow and say, hey, you know, I'm sold out for Christ and I'm gonna go with it. You're gonna have certain, you know, components along your walk that may cause you to second guess, may cause you to do certain things, but you still keep going. So I'll start with you, Renwick, then I'll come back to DC. Just talk about, you know, what keeps you going, what keeps you motivated as an independent artist, you know, as someone that is, you know, basically what you're selling, what you're producing, what you're presenting 24/7 is Christ. You know, what are some of the challenges that you face and what keeps you going in that life?
No problem. Before, I'm going to connect this all together, I got to shout out Darnell Nolan. And a lot of people in my country were really proud of me and stuff like that when they saw that I got a distribution deal. And Darnell was very instrumental in navigating that. And he's a person that took a chance on me and still to this day supports me and mentors me and encourages me. So Darnell, big up yourself. Thank you very much. I see you on the live. I gotta give honor where honor is due.
Tonight is a special night. You know, I've always been doing my live. Darnell haven't joined one time in my 50,000 live. Now the one night you're on, Darnell showed up. So that's love right there.
Darnell is amazing at what he does, and he cares for you beyond the deal. And that's what I love about Darnell. I had some stuff that I need it worked out, and he got it done for me. So Darnell, big up yourself, my brother. Enough love. Now, before I even got to meeting like a Darnell, I had to go through the process of being shaped, of being molded. I had seasons where I had the wrong I had the wrong motives, right? And I had to be realigned. I had to be corrected. The skill set had to be sharpened, right? But one thing I've learned in this journey and to embrace is that my obedience to God is more important than the applause of the crowd. Because there are things that I did that I never received the results or applause or recognition that I anticipated. But nevertheless, the most important thing in that equation was my obedience to fulfill my assignment. So one of the things that keep me going, and trust me, as an independent artist, we have challenges. I'm not gonna come in and lie. Like we face, and one of the biggest challenges that we face is having the resources to do things on the level that we can do it at, right? And I've had to trust God for the provision. I've had to trust God for the tenacity, the focus, the drive. But it all comes back to what keeps me going is the why factor, is that this is not a hobby, this is my assignment. And if I don't release the music that God has given to me, they have somebody out there who will miss an opportunity, or I would have missed the opportunity to reach someone with the gift and the ability that God has given to me. So that's my daily conviction. And what keeps me going is that beyond the gift, beyond the talent, beyond the anointing, this is really an assignment. They got people out there that need an encounter with God. And if the Lord can use me as a tool in his hands, that is all that matters.
Love that. Don't go anywhere, because I want you to share your socials and what you got coming up before you drop. But I'll ask DC that same question before he also shares his socials and everything else. Go ahead, DC.
Yeah, just to really piggyback on everything that Renrick was saying, the challenges are many. I mean, for me, my challenge really was culture per se, because I'm living in a Caribbean country and predominantly trying to do hip hop and Christian hip hop at that. Just the backlash from everywhere, not just from the people in the world, but also from the church, because for a long time, Caribbean church culture shunned any kind of really progressive movement. It has been a bit of let's stick with the old way, because we know the old way works, and not much innovation. But I'm happy to say that now we're actually getting there, we're actually becoming innovative and that stuff. So it was a lot of backlash at first when I would get invited to places and I'm there on stage and I'm starting to rap, and then all the church mothers are concerned.
What am I listening to? Yeah,
I can see some, yeah, you know, starting to mouth the words in foreign tongues to, you know, I don't know, man. I've had challenges. I've had people come up to me and tell me, you know, you should don't rap, just don't do it, do something else. But as Renwick said, assignment is very important. A friend of mine, I'll never forget this, because he told me this one time. I went to an event, one of his events. I don't know how many of the people here know who Samuel Madass is, but I went to one of his events and I was slated to perform, and I was just thinking, listen, I'm here, this entire cast is a cast full of worship leaders, they're about to go worship, so I might as well sing a worship song too. And I remember him confronting me at the side. He pulled me aside and said, listen, if you don't do what you have been gifted and assigned to do, then the people that you're supposed to meet in this place tonight will not be reached, because they are probably here thinking, oh, this is just another worship event. And then you know, just encountering something different, like what you have, could really be the spark. It really be the sparking point to really change your life. As Paul said, some sow, some water, some reap. And you never know, you can be the person that could sow the seed, or maybe to someone that's watering the seed of watering the word of Christ in their life in some way, form, or fashion. And then really, you just never know. And so, like, from that day on, I decided, you know what? Regardless of what happens, who says what? Listen, I have to do what God has entrusted me to do. I mean, it's not by mistake, or it's not perchance that I have the gifts and the talents and the skill sets that I have. And like, I know that the challenges are there. The challenges are plenty, but you know, we serve a God who is above challenges. We serve a God who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above everything that we could ever ask or see. So when I feel like, listen, I'm stuck and the things aren't going the way I want them to go, whether it be resource-wise or like the vision is not coming together, I know I can always trust God for it, because you know, He's the one that initially gave it to me. And so it just out of obedience, I'm just carrying it out, just doing exactly whatever it is that He asked me to do, however He asked me to put it down, to layer it, to write it, to enunciate it. You know, I'm just trying to do it so that God could be glorified and our lives can be changed.
I love that. DC, definitely want to, you know, keep the conversation going, bring you back the next time, you know, just to kind of just hear your full story again. Tonight, we just wanted to, starting the Buzzing Indie Spotlight, we wanted to, you know, spotlight independent artists, you know, bring you before our audience, you know, have your music on one of our playlists. If anyone search Spotify for, you know, Gospel Music Buzz, they're going to find your music on that playlist, just to kind of be a conduit again with being, you know, understanding independent artists, you know, getting what is 5 minutes, 10 minutes, you know, a feature somewhere, or what might, you know, it goes a long way. So that's kind of why we started this series. So definitely I appreciate you hopping on here on a Friday night. I'm sure you can be doing a million and one other things on a Friday night. I appreciate you. See, exactly. So, you know, you could be doing all that. But before you go, give us your socials. So anyone that wants to follow you, they kind of know what platform you're mostly active on, and go ahead and give us your socials.
Yeah, man. So I'm mostly, to be honest, I'm just trying to multitask a lot, but mostly I'm here on IG at IMDC. That's I.AM.DC, IMDC. You can head over to Facebook. It's DC, that's DISI. You can see my regular Facebook profile at Rondell DC Holder. That's RONDELDISIHOLDER. On TikTok, it's at IMDC as well. And that's really where I'm at. TikTok, Facebook, Instagram. Content is there, music is there. You can check me out on Spotify, Apple Music as well. Got everything there at DC, DISI. You search for it, you'll find it, man.
Appreciate you. And I will go ahead and we'll add that as well too. Once we post the video, we'll go ahead and tag you, and there is certain one can go ahead and follow you. Renwick, hit us with your socials. Let us know what your social is before you drop as well to give the people your socials one more time.
No problem. It's my first and last name, Renwick Dewsbury. On Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, YouTube, everywhere. It's Renwick Dewsbury.
Appreciate you, man. I know you're in between a lot of stuff too, man. Appreciate you as well hopping on. Definitely, we will speak again, man. I know, you know, I saw you dropped a little, you know, a little clip, the little mental health clip. You know, I'm not even going to touch that right now, but I see we definitely got to talk a bit more about that and what's progressing there. And I'll also, you know, have you back to just to give an overview on the DEMROC Awards and everything else that's happening there, and those key dates that are coming up as well too. You know, we're going to do a separate session with that, so you can kind of go through and break all that down for us.
No problem.
All right, guys, have a good one.
Thank God you bless you, Sharon. You keep up the good work. Thank you very much for even having a platform like this. Just like we had to progress and through our struggles, I'm sure that you also have your struggles that you progress through. So please keep on going. We need gospel music, Buzz. God bless you, my brother. Thank you for having us.
Thank you for sure.
Thank you for opening the platform to allow just us to be here. Really appreciate you, man. God bless. Look forward to being here again if God permits. Blessings to everyone on the Buzz Media Spotlight Live. Blessings, love y'all. Y'all take care, man. Peace.
Take care. Renee, I am bringing you up now. Renee, actually, shout out to the Saga. We're going to be bringing her up right now. We'll bring you in now. Bringing you in right now. What's up? What's happening?
Hey, y'all. Everybody, how y'all
what's
doing?
What's good? How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Well, I'm well. You see, the love is already pouring in. Shout out to.
I know. My husband is so embarrassing. Listen, man,
that's what he's supposed to do. That's where it is. So go ahead and introduce yourself to the people. Let them know, who is Renee Ashley. Just give them a little snippet of who they're speaking to tonight.
Okay, hey everybody. My name is Renee Ashley. That is my real name. I do primarily worship music. I'm kind of on this journey right now of opening myself up to the world and seeing where God takes me. So far, so good. And I'm so blessed to be here and have y'all support.
She's gonna speak in a very humble light. She's gonna kind of downplay a little bit of what it is. But before we get into the single and all of that, there's one question that we've been asking forever is that, I've seen you at various worship sessions, leading worship at your local church. And the question was always, when are you going to release a record? When are you going to release song? When are you going to release music? And after kind of, being in the cut, doing what you're doing for a while, then you went ahead and released it. Just talk a little bit about knowing that you're called to do what you're doing, but still, doubting yourself before even going forward and releasing that for a single.
Yeah, I think self-doubt has always been a major hurdle for me. I've been singing for a very long time. My sis Wyo is here, who is your wife. We were in a group together. Like, she was like a big sister to me, and all people were surrounded. They were grown adult people, and they always encouraged me. So at the time when I would sing a lot, and I still sing a lot, but I tried to do background. Young age, I was 10 years old when I do background vocals. And then once my name started to get a little bit of recognition just from going around with the group and also Righteous and all this stuff, I was maybe 14, 15, 16, around there. And I always knew that there was a calling on my life. I was just too afraid to take the leap, to jump out on faith. And I remember I used to lead worship and I used to shake. Like, I was so scared. I would shake, I would cry, like, I can't do it. And it was so difficult for me to open up. It really takes a lot of courage to get on stage and open yourself up and be used by the Holy Spirit. So I actually started to work on my own music at the top of 2018, actually. I was working with somebody who's like a big brother to me, which is Christopher Thompson. And we started to work on this like R&B kind of music, but I knew that that was not where my heart was. I knew that it was kind of like my safe way out, because worship is just so, it's such a vulnerable thing to do. And so I was like, okay, I'll do this like R&B stuff. That music never saw the light of day because it just never felt authentic. So finally this year, is it this year? I feel like the year just flew by. The top of I released my first single with her today. It did well, and here I am releasing. I released my second single. And yeah, that's been that kind of fear and just believing in what God set up, which is to just take the leap into music and see, you know, where it goes.
I'm glad you kind of, you know, recap, because even though you were doing, you know, you mentioned, you know, being in a group together with Yannette, with your sister, with, you know, with a few others, and also singing with Richie Righteous, which, you know, a lot of us know Richie Righteous in the CHH space and so forth. And, you know, you guys have been going around, you've been doing a whole lot of that, but it was still, even though you're out there and you're doing it, but that's still, you know, feeling that same self-consciousness, feeling that same self-doubt, but kind of pushing through and going forward past that. And again, now, you know, you're two singles in now, My Everything is out, great song. I always know that, you know, there's a few artists, whenever they drop music, if I don't see it from a label or I don't see it from someone else, I always know because my wife is blasting it in the house. You're one of those artists that the minute it's dropped, I can be doing something and I'm gonna hear it blasting. I'm gonna turn around, I'm gonna ask her, I'm like, who's that? And then she's gonna be like, that's so and so. So that's when the new song was coming out, that's the minute it dropped, that's exactly what was happening. And I was like, okay, let's go ahead and get that song added to the playlist, and let's kind of just, you know, keep pushing it on our end as well. And I saw there's a live that you did, because you mentioned you have a worship event that's coming up. I want to kind of just have you take a few minutes, talk about that event, talk about the end goal, you know, of the fundraiser part. And there's a few things that you're doing that I thought was really nice I want to touch on, but I'll have you just talk about the event.
Yeah, of course. So I'm having a worship night event. It's called Everything Worship. Looking to kind of brand this Everything Worship and hopefully take it to other states and just make sure that at the end of the day, yes, we're artists and things like that, but we are supposed to worship, right? That's the purpose of all of this. It's not the glitz and glamour. Of course, that will come for you, the awards and that will come if that's for you. But even if it doesn't, that's not the purpose. That's not the point of what we do. So Everything Worship is going to be on November 4th. I'm so excited. It's just a night of worship. I am praying for breakthrough, chains loose. I want people to scream, cry, shout, run. Like, I really want it to be a true night of worship, not this kind of thing where people come and they, like, you know, they want to get off. Like, this is the time for us to lose. And I have this idea that there shouldn't be a set. I just didn't feel right about that. And so my idea was, whatever people can afford to pay to come in, that's what I want them to pay. And to me, that just feels right. It is a work event, so I don't want to exclude anybody. I want everybody to come in, and this is just for everyone to come and worship. And the point of the fundraiser is I am hopefully going to be able to record a live album at the top.
I'll be able to record a live album.
That's my purpose. That is what I really want to do. I think that I can flow better live, and I can just tap into the Holy Spirit. I have this thing like making up these prophetic songs on the spot. I want to be able to show myself fully. And so I think a live recording would be to do that. My goal is $15,000, and I'm believing that I can do that. I'm believing that the Lord will help in that venture. This worship night before, so not only is it to worship, but it is to raise money for this.
You know, I love that, right? Because again, there's the purpose behind it, but also, you know, kind of not putting a cap on it, right? Because hey, someone shows up and they're like, hey, you know, even though you may say, you know, you set a ticket price for $10, $25, $35, someone shows up and they want to, you know, they want to give $100, they want to give $1,000, they want to give whatever it is towards it. Like, why just put a, you know, a simple price? And so when I heard that, I was like, oh, that's brilliant. I love that. So definitely, and you know, as you start to even talk, you know, talk more about that and so forth, definitely, you know, feel free to tag us, you know, share it to us and so forth, so that we can help to get the word out on our end. But you know, definitely it's really great just to, you know, see kind of from the, you know, knowing the supporting, you know, you supporting others and kind of being there in a lot of, you know, other individuals, you know, careers per se in that light, but kind of seeing you, you know, step in front and taking on that as well too, and just doing that, knowing that you're called to that. I say, you know, continue to do that for sure. But also, you know, even in those moments where, you know, those slowdown happen as well too, you know, just, you know, take that with stride as well. You know, there's every single season with everything else that you're doing, but you know, now is your go season clearly, and you know, you're moving ahead, and you know, continue to do that, and you got the support. Because I, you know, I would say when I brought on, who was it? I brought on Saga, brought on your husband about, you know, a week or so ago to talk about some stuff that he had going on. And the first thing he said was, you know, my wife has XYZ, she has that. So clearly you're getting that push and that support. He took his few minutes to, you know, spend the whole time talking about, you know, what you got going on. So that's good to see as well too from that ending. Rewind the comment, Jeanette said, I'm beyond proud of you, Renee, and I'm excited to watch how God will use you around the world. See, so there you go. Carlos, what's up, man? Yeah, so definitely. And as you start, you know, going to different events and venues and so forth, this guy right here, Carlos, definitely will be someone I'll connect you with as well. Carlos put on some of the dopest Urban Soul Cafe events and just about anything that is happening. You know, he's amazing. Big supporter of independent artists and so forth, kind of giving them a platform to do what they're doing as well too. So you know, definitely we can talk offline about that. But you know, give yeah, we've seen the love coming in. I'm proud of you, Renee. I'm super proud of you, Tamika, Marshall. But yeah, give the people your social, you know, let them know where they can connect with you, where you active most, you know, the event that's coming down again. We're going to be sharing the event and so forth. But you know, before you actually share your socials, just kind of give a word of encouragement for someone that was kind of exactly where you were a few years ago, knowing that you're called to do something, knowing that you're anointed, knowing that you're talented to do it, but still allowing self-doubt, allowing all these different things to kind of just keep you in a place where you just didn't want to reach out, you didn't want to launch forward, you didn't want to do anything, but now you're doing it. So kind of talk to someone that is just stuck in that place right now.
I mean, I would say if you're stuck in that place of fear, there is no shortcut. You're never going to wake up one day and all of a sudden not be fearful, not doubt. But that is the grace, that's the purpose of being connected with the Holy Spirit. My mantra, my motto this year has been with fear. That is what I all year. I'm shaking right before I lead worship. I'm like, Lord, I'm so scared, I'm so terrified. But if you know you're called, and if you know you're hearing the Lord's voice, if you know your heart and your soul and your gut, you feel what you're supposed to be doing, you just have to jump out on faith, right? Everybody, not artists. If you're thinking about going to school and you're fearful, you know, you've been out for a long time, but you're not sure if you should go back, or even gospel music buzz, right? Like this platform, and you know, sometimes you might feel fearful, like, oh my gosh, I don't know if it's gonna go here, if it's gonna go there. You know, I'm investing a lot into this thing. So this goes for you, just have to do it scared, because you never know where God is gonna take you, you know, and you never want to look back and think like, oh, I wish I would have. Or, oh God, I wish, you know, you never want to be in that space. And that is the conclusion that I had to come to. Hey, Renee, are you willing to look back and pop, regret not taking the leap? Like, will you be able to live with yourself? My answer was no. I was fearful sometimes. I still am insecure sometimes. But that is an active enemy to make sure that nobody hears what the Lord has put inside of you. hear out of God. So he is using that on purpose to shut you up. And so you have to make a conscious decision to say, I will not shut me up. In fact, I'm going to do this as big and as bold as I possibly can. And wherever the Lord is going to take me, he's going to take me. And so just that is the encouragement tonight. Do it scared. Do it scared. Because you don't want to look back and regret.
There you have it, Jill. Do it scared. Go forward. No shortcut. Indeed, Darnell. Go ahead and give us your social, Renee, before you drop. Go ahead and give everyone your social so they can kind of follow this journey.
Of course. I'm most active on Instagram and TikTok. My Instagram is at super_. There is a story behind my Instagram name, which I think I will never change it because of that story. One day, maybe I'll tell that testimony. So at superwoman_, SUPERWUMAN_. My TikTok is Renee_Ashley. Active on that. So go ahead and follow me
there. Y'all. Renee, thank you. Thank you so much for popping on tonight, speaking to us. Definitely will stay connected to everything that's going on. Appreciate you. Enjoy the rest of your Friday evening. All right.
Thank you, guys.
All right, guys. We are going. Kimberly, I'm going to bring you up now. Dre and Leah, I have you guys coming up right after Kimberly. Kimberly, I'm going to go ahead and bring you up now. Appreciate y'all hanging out with us. We're going. Kimberly, all the way from Canada. Kimberly, what's up? How are you?
I'm doing well. Let me turn this up. Make sure. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. It was blurry. Okay. Yep. I'm good. I can hear you.
Okay. Amazing.
Appreciate you hanging in. Appreciate you hanging in there and, you know, popping on this evening to chat with us. So go ahead and give the people a little bit of an intro. Who is Kimberly?
Amen. Kimberly Adde is a worshiper. Kimberly Adde is a mommy, a wife. I'm a lover of all things Jesus Christ. I go hard for him on stage, off stage. I'm passionate about worship. I'm passionate about worshiping with God's people. I have so much joy when I worship with God's people. So whenever you see me on stage, I could be flipping, skipping, running, jumping. It's just the joy of the Lord and the joy that I have worshiping with God's people. So that's me in a nutshell. I'm going to give it all that I got every chance that I get. And I'm grateful to God for the gifts that he has given me. And I just want to use them to glorify his name. That's me.
I love it. I love every part of those statements. And I can say that because I think when I first got introduced to you through Danielle Salmas Records, a few years back, definitely, I think when we were talking then just with everything else, you know, that was in store, even coming out of the pandemic and just kind of, you know, still continuing to stay focused and just doing everything. So it's great to see, you know, a few years in, you're still going strong. Like you said, you're still giving it every single thing, you know, you got some new music out right now that we're gonna get into in a second, but you also have quite the itinerary. I must say that is because you're all over the place. You know, for the last few months.
Oh my goodness. I don't even think I'm busy enough. There's so many places that I need to be, but God is gonna make the way.
So talk about that, you know, how things picking up right now, you know. You're gonna be in you're gonna be in the US. You're right now you're based out in Canada. What part of Canada are you based out of?
I'm based in Toronto, Canada. Toronto, stand up. Toronto, stand up. Toronto, Ontario.
Is that where Drake is from? Is he from Toronto? Where in Canada is Drake?
Where's who from?
Drake, the rapper, Drake.
Drake. From Toronto. Well, I mean, I only follow Jesus music, but I think it is Toronto. It is.
I love that.
It is Toronto.
It was not a trick question. I love that.
My old Lord, where are you from? I don't know.
I love that. That's funny. But yeah, so I said, talk. So you just kind of going around. You know, you're in a lot of different, you know, ministry. Ministry locations and so forth recently. So just talk about when you're someone called you in to say, hey, you know, I want you to minister at this given location. Come, like, what is that preparation season like? Kind of going into that, like, what is typically, you know, handling that assignment? How important is that assignment when you're going in there? I know each location is typically different, but what is that preparation phase like?
First of all, I take the preparation process very seriously. It's not something that I take casually. Whenever someone calls me to minister, and my sister's online. Hi, Sissy. Whenever someone calls me to minister, if it's a month in advance, my gears are going way in advance. I'm asking the Lord, you know, what do you want me to sing? What do you want me to say? I put my sets together. I prepare scriptures. I go all out. Even if it's just something as casual as leading worship, it is something that is taken very seriously. I do not take it lightly, because other people just kind of bridge a couple of songs together and be like, all right, I know this is going to bring power of God down. I know this is, you know, going to bring Holy Spirit down. But I really like to... I really like to hear from God, and I prepare as much as I can, but I've always been the type of worshiper that's willing to throw the program out the window as well. So the preparation definitely is handled in a serious way, where it's like, hey, kids, got to go to bed. It's 7 o'clock. Mommy needs to focus. But I'm also prepared on that day to just go wherever God wants to take me. So, you know, when it comes to ministering in these different places, sometimes it can be a little bit difficult because I'm not only a minister, but I'm a mommy, I'm a wife. So in between, looking for sets, I'm making a sandwich, I'm getting someone water, I'm cleaning up spills, like I'm doing it all while trying to prep, and it's not always easy, but I'm grateful to God for the opportunity to do it, because there's many that don't have the opportunity to use what God has given them to bless others, and that's what I love about what God has called me to do.
And what you said is important, because I say that every single time. Women are so great at multitasking. I see my wife can be juggling like 50,000 things, and she's just constantly on the money. You give me like three things
constantly.
I'm already stressed.
Constantly.
I'm already like, what's
constantly.
Going on? Let me focus on this one thing only. So definitely, you know,
so
much is given, much is required, but you know, for sure. In that,
almost definitely. Most definitely. Like even on Friday this past weekend, I was blessed to minister at Redeemed Christian Center in Scarborough. And that was really powerful. I really enjoyed worshiping with Jesus House in Scarborough. But I ministered Friday, I ministered Saturday, I ministered Sunday, but Saturday I'm doing the kids' hair, I'm retwisting everybody's hair, getting ready. You know, I go, I come back, I empty everyone's lunchbox, I help everybody with homework, and then I iron my clothes. I'm doing everything. So shout out to all the mommies in ministry out there. Super moms.
For real. No, definitely not gonna say anything about that, because I think you nailed it spot on. Now, for this new single that is out right now, Grateful.
Yeah.
Grateful. So I know Grateful is the first single, you know, of a few that you're gonna be releasing off of the upcoming project. Mm-hmm. So kind of starting with Grateful, give us the backdrop. Like what, you know, what does Grateful, like what inspired the song, you know, just the listen to the lyrics, you know, we can pull a lot from it. But for you, like, how was the song birthed?
Honestly, I was in my room one day and I was really thinking about how every time that I found myself in a difficult situation, the Lord always came in on time. Whether it was financially, whether it was with my children, whether it was in my health, even my vocals at times, whatever the situation was, I found that God always provided. He always showed up on time. He has remained faithful in my life from a little child up until now, ministering for over 20 plus years in the gospel ministry. He has never failed me. I was thinking about the fact that there are so many doors that God has opened and has, you know, allowed me to walk through, and I didn't pick up the phone and call anybody. I was thinking about the times where ministers would call me and say, you know what, I was asking God, you know, who should I put on their program? And God would lift up my name before them. I said, God, I'm grateful. I'm grateful. And then the lyrics started to come to me. He's a mighty good God, and I'm grateful. He's fighting for me. It started to just flow. And that's how it was birthed. And then coupled with the fact that, look, I'm grateful to Jesus Christ for his sacrifice. I've got something to be grateful for because I was able to give birth to two children. I've got a husband. I'm grateful for my life. I'm grateful for strength. Everybody, all of us, even if it's one thing. And this is why I think this is a song for everybody. And I'm just so blown away by the support. Everybody has something that they are grateful to God for. And this is why, you know, I think this is the right song for the season. And this is why I believe that God gave it to me. And I'm so excited to have it out there and everybody just loving on it and loving on me. I'm grateful.
No, I love that for sure. Because definitely anyone that we've shared the song with, anyone that, you know, even had conversation about the song, definitely do love the song. It's picking up. I know Lonnie and team over at Reach Gospel.
Yeah.
Song of the week as well this week.
They did.
So, you know, definitely the song is picking up traction everywhere. So it's a great song all together. So no pun intended.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
On the grid for sure. No, in terms of, you know, I guess timeline. So I know you're looking, when are you looking to release the actual full project? Is that more of a 2024 situation? Are you going to be dropping some other singles in between? Like what's kind of, you know, what is your musical timeline looking like? If, you know, just if we can squeeze anything else out of you in terms of that.
I am looking to, I'm currently working on my next single.
Okay.
The project is currently in the works. And I'm trying to drop everything in 2023. So before the end of this year, I'm trying to drop it all. So y'all pray for me. Y'all pray for me.
we got a few. Let me see. We got a few comments here. Date night, that babysitting. When we put him first, we can't go wrong. Congratulations.
Amen.
Prosperity. We have someone else.
Thank
here.
You.
Said the comment I just spent. I've had Grateful on repeat since the day it came out. Such a great song with so much meaning. A.M. Forever His. Oh, I am forever His. Sometimes these Instagram names be a little tricky. But no, so listen, man, it's definitely, and I think, you know, the it's great that you've surrounded yourself with a great team that's helping to bring a whole lot of this into fruition. I mean, even when it comes to graphics, when it comes to anything that you guys have been releasing, I can say for certain 100% it's always releasing, you know, with excellence. It's always just a methodical thought process around the rollout.
Yes.
You know, you got the new video that's out right now. For anyone that has not seen the visuals for this, you guys need to see it, need to check out her YouTube channel. I'll have you share all your socials and such this now. But, you know, what was that? Just touch a little bit in terms of, you know, just the importance of surrounding yourself with the right team when you're called and when you're, you know, when you're assigned to do something, but trying to figure out who are those other pieces that can come together to help you push the vision forward.
Yeah, most definitely. It is imperative that you surround yourself with people that, first of all, not yes men, because you don't want them to kind of, okay, I'm yes in everything you're doing, negative and positive. You want to surround yourself with people that are trustworthy, that are spirit-led, and that are not jealous of where God is taking you, but willing to support you. That's really important, because oftentimes we surround ourselves with people that want to be in our shoes, and you can't support me if you want to be me. You know what I mean? So I think it's really important to seek out people that are spirit-led. They have their heart is on kingdom business. They're kingdom minded. They're focused on souls and spreading the message of Jesus Christ, and they're willing to push you and you're willing to push them, because this is a partnership thing. This is not just me doing it by myself. We're all going to the same place. We're aiming for glory. We all have the same goal. So it's important that you surround yourself with people that are like that, and also pray to God, you know, Father, you know, hey, here's my circle. Please weed out whoever is not with me, whoever wants to cause disturbances, whoever is just, you know, causing me to not focus, whoever's draining me, whoever's, you know, draining my time and my effort and my draining me emotionally. Please reveal those persons to me and replace them with people that are willing to pour into me, replacing with people that are willing to encourage me. Replace them with people that are willing to pray with me and for me and push me. That is so important, because when you don't have people that are pushing you, you can push yourself, but you can go a lot further if you have people around you that are saying, hey, you go, girl. Go ahead, brother. You can do it. We believe in you. And with this song, honestly, I'm so grateful for my city, because they have supported me. They have pushed me since I've been in this industry since the age of 5 years old. They've been pushing me. I'm so grateful for my husband. A lot of people don't know that my husband is the one that actually shoots all my videos. I have 3 singles out, and every single one of my videos, he has shot the videos. My husband is the one that also is a photographer, so he also does the artwork. And my sister is a graphic designer. My husband is a graphic designer. So I'm so grateful to have people in my family that are there to support me. And I have people around me that are able to text and send me voice notes to say, Kim, keep pushing, girl. So having the right circle is imperative. Imperative.
Love that. I think that's great. And I feel as though, you know, that right there is going to be a lot of people's prayer, because I think you just said a lot of things there, those replacing. So y'all, if you see come next week, you know, some people start to fall out of your life, you know what you just prayed
now.
You know what you pray for.
You got a swift answer. He answered quickly.
Exactly. don't go back banging, you know, when those people start.
Don't go back. You know, if God exposes them, it's for a reason. It's for a reason. Because he's about to send people that don't want to be you, but want to push you. Mm. Amen. Man, glory.
Listen, glory to God. Listen.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
I'm with you. I'm with you with that. Amen. Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. Indeed to that. Let the people know, because definitely once the full project is out, we're definitely gonna be circling back just to kind of, you know, have you go through the entire process with us. You know, I just wanted to kind of have you on, give the people an update tonight.
Absolutely.
It seems like everyone is here. He said, Lord, send the help. Yep, amen. Come on now, that will preach.
Yeah.
So let the people know, you know, your socials. You know, I know you have, again, you're going to be in a lot of dates. You're going to be in West Palm. You're going to be a lot of different places. So what's
your... I'm going to be in Chicago as well. November.
Chicago as well. Chicago in November. Oof, Make sure you pack a jacket. Yep. It's gonna be cold.
I know.
But then again, you can.
And it's my first time being in Chicago in the winter. But you know what? Cold. I'm going to Prophetess Kamar Garner, and the atmosphere is gonna warm me up. I'm ready.
Man. So the people definitely have to follow everything that is happening so they can catch you at one of those locations. So go ahead and give us your socials.
Yeah, absolutely. So right here on Instagram, I am Kimberly Ade. On Facebook, Kimberly Ade Music, Kimberly Ade. YouTube, Kimberly Ade Music. Head on over, watch the video, be blessed, share it, because you're sharing the gospel of Jesus Christ. Somebody says, hey, Chicago winters ain't that bad. All right, I feel a little bit better, man of God. God bless you for that. So head on over to YouTube, check out the video, share it with somebody. It's going to bless you. I know it's going to bless you. The video is, the concept was, thought up and put together by my husband as well, Beyond Film and Photography. And it's just a powerful message. So share it with everybody you can. Click subscribe, click like, comment, and keep the videos coming, because I've been receiving so many videos of people dancing to the song. Keep it coming. I just love y'all so much. Mwah. Thank you.
Yeah, appreciate you so much for coming on this evening, for speaking with
us.
We can't wait to, you know, see everything else that's happening, you know, in and through your ministry. Definitely, if we're close by one of those locations, we'll try to make it there for sure, so that we can kind of just, you know, praise and worship in person, in the flesh, but continue to do what you're doing. Definitely, you know, someone said, I mean, like, must say some people are jealous of your relationship. Yeah, no, that's for sure. But yeah, thank you so much for hopping on. Enjoy the rest of your Friday evening.
Thank you so much.
And we will speak again. Thank you so much for popping on.
We will. God bless you. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you.
Bye, everyone.
All right. All right, y'all. We're still here. We got two more individuals we're bringing up. We got Dre and Leah, and then we're going to be bringing on the very last person. So stick around. This is great. We're getting to learn what's going on in the world of some amazing, amazing, independent, gifted individuals. Oh, here we go.
Hi.
What's happening, y'all?
How you doing?
I'm good. Look at them, y'all. Oh, they're just cute. Like, look like this, just hanging out, just chilling. Like, yeah, we here. We're ready to get into this, man. What's going on? How are y'all?
We're good. How you doing?
I'm good. Go ahead and, let the people know, you know, your names, and just tell us a little bit about you and about your ministry.
Well, Dre and Leah here. I am DeAndre. Of course, this is my wife Leah. Been married for about 14 years now.
Yeah.
And still excited for the Lord. Still excited about each other. No, that's the churchiness. But anyways, but yeah, we're excited. We've been singing together. I guess just before we got married, so maybe about 15 years, yeah. Maybe a little more than that, 15 and a half years. And it has been a journey. We've been able to, we have children. We're worship pastors at a church here in Cleveland, Ohio.
Yep.
My wife is originally from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And so Shout out to Milwaukee. Shout out to Saginaw, Michigan. That's where I'm from. Detroit, you know. We've been doing this for a while, and God has blessed us to just have an upbringing in church and in music ministry and, parents who are leaders in the church, pastors, bishops, and first ladies, and all that good stuff. And so we're just excited to have met you, Sharon, and the whole gospel buzz movement. God is, man, I remember we were with Writing Rounds a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
And God just, you were there. And yeah, to me, it seemed like you were kind of finding your way that year. I don't know if you were really, really new in the scene, but I don't think really too many people had heard of you at that time. And I could just see, man, within the last year and a half, that how God has just really blessed you, man. And you've been very productive and, you know, just connecting people and just a great resource. And so we're just so thankful for you, man.
Yeah, no, definitely. Yeah, I remember when I met you guys as well too. I think you know the whole Riding Around crew was kind of, you know, you guys were all around. You were singing, you know, doing what you do best. And you know, I was walking by and I was like, oh, this is nice. I'm gonna stick around. I'm gonna take my phone out. I'm gonna start recording it. Kind of, you know, just getting into that. So yeah, I'm really glad we even got the, you know, we got the connected as well too. So you know, you mentioned husband and wife, you guys, you know, doing life, you're doing ministry, yeah, you're doing music. You just had your event, you know, I know last Friday you just had your event, you know, just give us an update, you know, tell us about the event, you know, what was the purpose behind it, and you know, how was the event altogether?
The event was awesome. It was a very intimate setting. Not a, you know, typical worship thing, but it was more so like we wanted to share our original music from our new EP, and we were able to do that live. We sang all of the songs.
Oh, sorry, give us the name of the EP.
The EP is called With You I'm All Right, and that is the title track. That's one of the songs on the EP. And we were able to perform all of the songs on there. We also did one of the songs that we released back in 2011.
Our first single.
Which was also our first single. We performed that as well. We had a great turnout. We were able to share some of our story and talk about the meaning behind some of the songs. So we were really excited about that. We had a great response and people were, you know, enjoying themselves. So it was really great.
Yeah.
Talk about, were you gonna add something?
Yeah, I was gonna say, like, one of the really cool parts is the fact that we wanted to kind of get into like the marriage and the journey and, you know, how we connect with each other, how God has blessed us to write together, and so we kind of got to get into that a little bit more and kind of get into like our process and things like that. So it it wasn't a worship event, but we thank God that, you know, when you're welcoming him in, he's not going to be, you know, he's going to come in. And so the fact that we invited his presence in and then he came in and he blessed us real good. But in the midst of the kind of like a talk show type vibe, we could sense the presence of God. We had a beautiful worship moment and we could really connect and engage with everyone that was there. So it was a beautiful night.
Yeah, and I saw you guys had, you know, you also had a few friends there with you as well, too, that was also partaking in the night that were singing and so forth. Yeah. So, you know, I'm sure if there's any footage, if there's anything from there, definitely we're looking forward to seeing, you know, once those are up somewhere, because if I think I know you guys, I know there's definitely footage somewhere that you're going to be curating and you're going to be putting it out there. So we're going to be looking forward to that. The EP that you mentioned just now, how many tracks is on the EP and where can people purchase the EP right now?
Awesome. Yeah, there are 5 tracks. However, we will be eventually releasing it to streaming. Right now it's on our website, dreandleah.com. You can go there right now and check it out. You can hear some samples and purchase the EP. And then we also have a bonus track, which is a cover song that we've done. It's a worship song called Thinking Deep. And you can hear that as well. If you buy the EP, you can get that for free on our website. Once streaming comes out, that's coming out October 20th.
October 20th.
So you can also get the song on Apple Music, Spotify, anywhere. And that's October 20th, and Thinking will be a part of that as well. So on streaming, it will be 6 tracks.
Love that. And then that's going to be the bonus track. And I think when we were speaking before, you know, I thought that was a great strategy as well. Because I think there's no right and wrong way to say, hey, you have to do something this way versus the other. But kind of, you know, providing a channel where, you know, some of your really core supporters to be able to tap in, they're going to go through the site, they're going to go through certain things, and then kind of opening it up via streaming as well, eventually after the fact. I thought that was a great strategy. You know, again, kudos to you guys and even thinking through. And I think a lot of it too, you know, and I feel like as independent artists, you know, Definitely. And you know, that's why I like doing what I'm doing and just, you know, talking to everyone and listening to their stories and, you know, seeing what they're doing. What there's no direct way to say, hey, this is the only way to do it, because if that was the case, everyone would have been doing it this way and everyone, you know, would have been you know, doing everything perfectly. But you know, there's trial and errors, there's different way to go about what you're doing. So I think, you know, you guys just kind of, you know, being, you know, intuitive enough to say, hey, let's try this, let's try that, and kind of going forward from there. So that's great in and of itself. You know, now that the event, you know, I know you guys are planning a lot for that EP release, now that it's done, it's finished now, do you feel like you can breathe now? You feel like you can finally relax a little bit, or are you already planning the
Oh
next
no.
thing?
I don't
The
know.
thing is, we've been talking about this, and man, it's exhausting. I have to learn.
It can be.
I gotta learn to sit down somewhere and take a moment
Yeah.
to take in the
Just
moment.
a pause
Just a pause.
after.
I'm working as well as DC. I also teach at a school. I work at a school.
Okay.
And so how I don't know what type of school he works at, but the school I work at, we deal with some students that deal, you know, they have like some trauma, some emotional disturbances, things like that. And we kind of work with them on managing their emotions and, you know, dealing with behaviors and things like that. So my students don't really necessarily, they're not able to go to public school. So it's a high stress job. It is a hands-on job. And so having that moment to kind of pause after the event, I really didn't take advantage of that. But God did allow me some grace in there just a little bit. But we're actually on to the next thing,
Oh,
which is
really?
our holiday joy event. We were blessed to produce it last year. It's like a musical production, kind of like, you know, stage production. But it's very musical based, and maybe we can talk more about that later on because I don't want
For
to hear
sure.
from your questions. But yeah, my wife, she gets on me. I got to learn how to pause, but I, you know,
He's
I
a
got
big
to, you got
dreamer.
to.
He's a big, big dreamer.
Great, but you gotta also learn to take in those moments, man. You know, you gotta learn just to, whenever you get those wins, man, you know, take it in, you know, pause, enjoy it. Like, hey, you know, we're gonna plan the next thing, but let's take a day or two and just, you know,
Right.
let's be grateful and let's be thankful of this one that just happened, and then we move on to the next. The rest, you're always gonna keep going. You'll never enjoy it. So
That's
that would be
wisdom right there.
You gotta listen to your wife, man. Listen to your wife. Carry
Yes,
usually.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
Tell
Yes, honey. Yes, baby.
Before I let you guys kind of, you know, share your socials and such with us, but you know, talk, give a word of encouragement, right? Because you're an independent artist. You guys are doing a whole lot, right? You're dreaming big, you know, you're doing a lot of stuff. You're not setting limits on what you're doing. As an independent artist, you know, someone, DC and Renwick and a few others were talking early about resources, about a bunch of different ways, right? You know, things that you can stumble, but still pushing forward. So, you know, what keep you guys going? Because again, you're doing life, you're doing music together. You know, if you have a bad day from the family side, and that goes with the music, that goes everywhere. It's not like, hey, I'm going to the studio. Like, I'm at the studio. We're both at the studio. So, you know, like, what are some of the things that help you guys in, you know, just kind of pushing forward and progressing forward in spite of everything else around?
I wanted to go first. My wife is gonna she's gonna bless y'all with some wisdom, because she always do. She always has these amazing nuggets. But I really wanted to just kind of like I said, with this particular situation, kind of having those moments to pause and kind of restructure. And like when Rick and DC was talking about, you know, that investment piece, that is important. And I think with our dynamic, I don't know if they have families or not, but with our dynamic, we have children, you know, married, got, you know, a house and all this stuff. And so it's very important to kind of take those moments. But I'm always challenged by, you know, like I believe both again, DC and Rick was talking about the why. You know what I'm saying? Why are we doing this? And, you know what I'm saying? We believe it's a calling. We believe that God has called us to this. And with that calling, there is a faith walk. You know what I'm saying? You're kind of just really just saying, Lord, I trust you. You called me to this. You called us to this. You put these ideas and all of this, and then you bless us with the resources. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes there's some investments that we have to make that do pull away from our household. And then there's those other opportunities mixed in with investment where, okay, God, I see you providing the resources. People are blessing. This opportunity is coming up. People want to sow into it, whatever the case is. So those kind of like keep you going because Kimberly was saying, it is a community and you want to make sure you're staying connected with those people that want to see you go forward. You know what I'm saying? I'm grateful for those people that want to see us do well and go forward. So it is a faith. It's trusting God and in everything. I'm excited to be, I'm excited. I'm humbled actually that I'm connected with a woman like Leah. You know what I'm saying? She has a lot of wisdom, a lot of insight. She, you know, I have to think about stuff because like you said, like I'm the dreamer. Like I have a lot of vision. I have a lot of dreams, but she's more like the logistics and analytics person. Okay. How do we approach this dream and this, you know, from a tactical or strategic standpoint? So I think that's the blessing in what we do in our partnership and in our marriage. Go ahead, Leah.
Well, I have a few things to say. So like you said, you know, we're husband and wife. Not only do we sing together, we worship together, we sleep together, we pray together. You know what I mean? Like it can be a lot, you know what I'm saying? But we have to find that balance as well. We're not able to do every single thing together. It's sometimes okay to do things as individuals, come back together and make it happen. Another thing is we have to decide what does success look like to us.
That's right.
We know our purpose. We know our purpose is to shine Jesus' light through our marriage, our music, and our family. That's the main thing that we're about. It's funny because we were living back in Milwaukee for a period of time, and we were in a transition because we were asked to move to Cleveland for a worship position here. Mm-hmm. And it was funny because we were watching Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, and we were just trying to figure out what we're going to do. And I really feel like God spoke to me in that movie. there was a line that said, he was like, Miles was like, how do I know when I'm ready? And he was like, you're not gonna know. It's just a leap of faith. That's all it is. Mm. And I was like, okay, God, I see you. And I felt like God is just like telling us to just leap, just do it. Yes, like they were saying earlier tonight, you know, you have to do it scared. You don't know what the outcome is, but as long as God is with you, you can do it. You can keep going. So that really encouraged me.
And I feel Jesus.
Right. Yeah.
I
be encouraged.
I love that. I'm gonna have you guys share your socials, but before you do, Carla said y'all shoot hoops together too, asking for a cousin.
No. I'm not good. No.
Carlos, you're such a fool. Yeah. You can't take Carlos anywhere. Go ahead and give the people your socials so they can connect with everything you guys got going on.
Yes. We are Dre and Leah on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, and on YouTube, Dre and Leah Live. You can follow us. We got some new videos coming out soon. Live video of the Jesus song and Sinking Deep are coming out. So be looking for that as well.
Yeah, October 20th. The EP is coming out to streaming October 20th. So be on the lookout for that. And then one more thing, December 9th, here in Cleveland, Ohio, the Holly Joy Experience. We'll be back second year. Thank you, God, for allowing us to produce that. It's going to be a great time. Marcus Cole is one of our featured artists, and there's a lot of other people that's going to be joining us. So if y'all in the area or, you know, whatever, come see us.
Hang out with us.
Love it. And we'll definitely be sharing it as well on our platforms just to get the word out there and ensure that everyone knows what's what's happening there. So again, appreciate both of you guys for popping in, you know, making sure you stop in and, you know, chat with us tonight. So continue to do, you guys are doing a great thing together. So continue what you're doing, and, you know, make sure, you know, Dre, make sure you just kind of, you know, chill a little bit. Enjoy the moment. Enjoy the moment, right? Take it easy, y'all. Appreciate you.
All right. Night. Thank you.
Take care. Good night. All right. We are bringing in our final person of the evening. Dallas, let me see what you said here. Y'all better leave. Man, you better praise your wife. Yeah, for sure. Lois, the man was definitely on point. All right, Kier, if you're there, I'm going to bring you in right now. Appreciate you guys hanging with us all the way to the end. Appreciate y'all hanging with us.
Hi.
Hey, what's happening? How are you?
How are you? I am good. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you. I know you were busy doing a bunch of other stuff, but still found some time to come on here with us. So appreciate your patience. Appreciate you hopping on.
Thank you for having me. I am sitting backstage right now, but I said, let me hurry up and find a little small setup, make it happen.
So I guess let's start by, you know, introduce yourself for those that may not be familiar with who you are, you know, let people know who you are and just, you know, it's a little snippet about yourself.
My name is Kiera Davin. I'm from Detroit. I'm a singer-songwriter. I've been doing this a long time. I don't want to tell my age, but long enough. I'm a mom, I'm a wife, and I'm excited to be here and speaking with you about this amazing song that I had the privilege of writing for our worship team at Embassy Covenant Church. Shout out to Embassy, Aroma Worship. So yeah, that's it. I also have Revival. That's out now and doing well, so I'm extremely proud of that record. So yeah.
Before we get into and thank you for that. Before we get into the mm-hmm. music part here, you know, you were recently at an event with our mutual friend Josh. I was supposed to be there. I'm sure that's probably why Josh not picking up my calls.
I just probably
this is the mm-hmm. second year I was supposed to be there, and I was not there, so Josh is basically, he's not answering my calls right now.
But
aside from that, how was the event? Kind of, you know, tell us a little bit about the worship gathering.
First of all, shout out to Josh Hurt and the worshipers gathering in Texas. It was phenomenal. I mean, just from the time that we stepped foot in sound check all the way to the end, and it was such a beautiful flow. From one leader to the next. And I love the fact that there's so much freedom when you do the worshipers gathering. This is my second year doing it. And this year was just no different. I enjoyed working with all the other artists, and everybody was just so humble and sweet and kind, and just whatever you needed, wherever you went, they had your back. So I am so happy that I had the chance to get to do it this year, and I hope I'll be back. But it was amazing. It was amazing. It was Antoine Cook and David Wilfer and Christabel Clack. It was just a good time. It was such a good time.
Love that. Love that for sure. Before we talk about the new song that's out, you mentioned Revival, and, you know, and just, you know, mm-hmm. being, you know, talk a little bit about, you know, about that particular record. Like, what was the inspiration behind that, you know, when that kind of say, hey, you know, I'm gonna release this out, I'm gonna do it, like, what was kind of the inspiration behind that one?
So Revival was released 2021, I believe, and that record was very special to me because I got to work with my nephew. His name's Josh Knight. Shout out to Josh. And I would get up in the middle of the night and I would just hear these songs and melodies, and I would literally just get my voice note and sing it and send it to Josh, and then we'd get together. And we did it so much, we were like, hey, let's just go ahead and put this record out and let the people hear, you know, what the Lord has given us. And I was extremely nervous because I'm like, live singing, it's a Goliath, right? Like, there's so much to contend with. You don't get to stop and do over and, you know, all the things that you can do when you have the protection of the studio. So that was a really great experience. But I think what inspired me the most with Revival was my dad, and just working, just giving him lyrics and sending him lyrics and him having the opportunity to hear just some of the songs that we wrote and attend the live recording before he passed away. And my dad passed away of COVID, you know, in 2020, I'm sorry, when everything first started happening with COVID. So it's just a special project for me because I got to share that with my dad and I got to share this with my family. A lot of my family helped produce, my husband, like I said, Josh, my sisters, like it was just a family affair. So I was really, 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 really blessed to be able to just put that record out. Yeah, and it's doing really well. So glory to God.
That's special. I'm glad, you know, you mentioned, you know, just kind of again, sorry to hear that, but I'm sure, like you said, you know, the fact that he was able to, you know, to be there, to be able to see the lyrics, to kind of see it pulled together. So I'm sure it holds an even more special part, you know, just in your whole fabric of music all together as well.
It makes me so grateful for my upbringing and just how much lyrics meant to my family. And like, even when it came to secular things, my parents were always like, hey, don't just listen to anything, see what those words mean, see what they're saying to you, because like music is a superpower. That's what, like, yeah. I like to call it, it's a superpower. So that thing stays with you, whatever it is. So make sure whatever you're depositing into your spirit, that is something that you don't mind being deposited into your spirit, you know, because there's a lot of wicked things out here. So yeah, I'm grateful. Yeah.
A comment here from Monarch Nashville says, Kira's Monarch family.
Hi guys. Yes, shout out to Monarch for giving the girl a shot. For giving the girl a shot. Thank you.
The new, you know, we can touch on the new, you know, on the new project now, but just, you know, from worship per se, because you've definitely made worship a posture, like that's not just, you know, something you do, but it's your lifestyle, is what you've embraced. Just talk a little bit about just fostering and always cultivating the presence of God wherever you go.
I always say, and I stick by this, and this is something that my mom taught me. My mom literally taught me everything I know about worship and Davidic worship and what it means to flow and just be in the presence of the Lord and how to be a good steward in the presence of the Lord. And it starts at home. I cannot get up and do something that I have not experienced at home. So I can't take you anywhere that I've never gone. And I can't introduce you to any other part of God that I have not experienced. So I can't sing about a healer if I don't know him to be a healer. You know, I can't sing about him being a deliverer if I have not experienced my own personal deliverance in my life. So I hope that everything that you experience from my ministry is a result of what I've done privately. So I love God and I take it seriously. I still believe that holiness is the way. I still believe that righteousness is not something that's unattainable, and neither is holiness. It's not something that goes out of style. It's not something that we can just decide or not decide. I believe that it should be a forever posture and it should be a forever journey for those of us who believe in God, that we should always strive to be pleasing to him and to give worship according to what he's asked us. Like, a lot of times we come into situations and we're leading worship, we make it about what we think, yeah, what the people want. We make it about the latest song, or thinking that we're gonna even catch in flows and things like that, and that's nice, but we have to worship according to scripture and how he told us to, in spirit and in truth. But there are also commands of things that we should do with our body, right? Like, if we're talking about God or we're singing about God,
all of us should be involved in that. So like sometimes we get in a headspace like, well, maybe I'm not the kind of person that likes to lift my hands. Well, you should be if you're worshiping the Lord,
yeah.
Because he told us to do that, right? We have Torah, we have Yada, all of the things that are scriptural about lifting our hands and just being expressive in our worship. So I think that if we just keep that at the forefront, doing it the way that he told us and then doing it the way that he engrafted in my heart to do it, I may not be like everybody else. I probably won't ever be able to do the trendy things, but I will always do what he's given me to do, the unique way that he's given me to do it. And I hope that everybody that listens or has a chance to come in contact with my ministry is encouraged to do the same, not be a replica of me, but be encouraged to do it the way that God has, you know, made them to do it.
So. Wow, that's beautifully said. Before
Thank
I know you.
You
know, I know you're in, you know, what you're doing, but before you do that, let's talk a little bit about the new project that is out right now. Before you give our socials, talk about the new project, name of it, you know, who's the collaborative with that, where people can get it.
Oh yes, yeah. So The Greatest, guys, is on every digital outlet. This is a super special song that I got to write, and shout out to Amir, the producer of this song and this and of the record for Aroma Worship, which is my home church, our praise team. And we did a live recording in December, actually on New Year's Eve. We did a live recording, and a lot of us submit a song, so it's not even just me that's writing on this project. You have amazing songwriters. Shout out to Alexis, to Thea, to Jocelyn. I'm scared to name people because I'm gonna get in trouble. But it was a lot of amazing writers that helped make this whole record really incredible. But The Greatest specifically was inspired by three things. It was inspired by a conversation. It was inspired by a sermon series that our bishop was teaching on about kingdom technologies, and it was inspired by a diagnosis. Right before I started writing the song, I really couldn't think of anything that I really wanted to say on this record, but right before this, my mom was diagnosed with stage 2 breast cancer, and I immediately thought that the Lord was about to give me like some kind of sad song or something, you know, like, we're gonna make it through, don't worry, hold your head up. But the Lord literally dropped this song in my spirit. And I was like, why am I hearing a song of celebration at a time where I feel the lowest? I feel so defeated. I feel frustrated. I feel angry. I'm tired. I'm like, I just lost my dad. Like, I am not prepared to lose my mom. And I just heard that melody in my mind. Not for a second, not for a minute, you won't ever stop being the greatest. And I'm like, man, I gotta sing a happy song. And the Lord is like, absolutely, because I'm at the end of this thing. We're not celebrating a death. We're getting ready to celebrate my healing hand, my strong right hand. So that's why you hear lyrics like, I'm like, this time to brag on the Lord then. Because if you're giving me this guarantee before we even begin the process of, you know, chemo and surgeries, then I can go back and look at the evidence. That's why it's a line that says, I have the greatest technology, you gave me a memory. And I call to mind every time you've been great. And then it says, you can ask Pharaoh's army, but they're not here to speak. They've all drowned in the sea. He'll never stop being the greatest.
Wow.
And if you go through scripture, you will find several instances where God has not only defeated, but he's destroyed. Like there is no evidence of Pharaoh's army because he drowned them in the sea. That was his doing. You know what I mean? And then the children of Israel, I think it's so amazing that when they went through the Red Sea, they were rejoicing, right? So they were going through something that they've never seen, I can't imagine what that looked like, but they were rejoicing because they knew who was taking them through it and what the end was. So I'm like, I am excited about the Lord. If I can find evidence in his word, then surely it encourages me to look back through my life and see the things that he has brought me from. So cancer is a small thing to God, and autism, like my daughter, is a small thing to God, and anything that we face is a small thing to God. So I'm like, if you can do that, you can do anything. I'm not worried. You conquered death, hell, and the grave. Like, what is a diagnosis to a God, right? So
my yes. God, see, we got a few. See, preach, Darna said this girl is good and true, bro. Kira is a true gift. Love this woman of God. I mean, you
thank
are
you.
Encouraging.
Thank you.
Encouraging.
I know, y'all. I get excited. That. But this is why you have a mind. You're supposed to remember the goodness of God. So while you're waiting on Him to do something, you can rejoice in what He already did while you're waiting. So I'm waiting on God and I'm rejoicing for what He already did. Wow. So I'm like, that makes me excited. Like, I love God. You are literally the greatest. Like, nothing compares to you.
Love. But y'all, this song is called The Greatest, or Open Worship.
Yes.
Definitely, you guys go ahead, stream it, download it, check it
stream
out.
It.
You know, if you're going through your season and you need Him to be great for you, you know, play this, know the place that it came from, and you know, continue to believe and continue to push forward. We got a Open Worship said we love you, Kira.
I love y'all. And listen, teach this song to y'all praise team, okay? It's
See,
time
there,
for us
there,
to
there
communicate
go.
The mind of God to our congregation. So teach the song to your praise team, too.
There you go. Y'all listening? Praise and worship leaders, you listening? Teach yourselves to your praise team.
You need the stems? Well, you need the stems. We hook you up.
See, there you go. See, Darnell said I fuss at Kira all the time. She still say God is the greatest.
Darnell is forever fussing. I, you know, and I have irrefutable evidence too. She's always fussing at me. One day I'm gonna share all our little messages so people can see.
That's funny. Kira, let the people know which platform are you mostly engaged on that they can follow you, they can kind of, you know, connect with you, and they can just follow in the journey what God is doing for you.
Instagram for sure.
Stems.
Oh, for
they're,
sure.
They're,
we got
a worship leader at their church in Ohio.
Congrats. Oh, right. They were just talking about
that. Yeah.
Congratulations, family. That's amazing. But I'm Instagram. I'm mostly Instagram and Facebook. I can't, that's all I can handle. So.
And what's your Instagram name?
I'm at Kira Daffin on any social media outlet. Yeah, just my first and last name.
All right, perfect. Kira, thank you so much for hopping on, for shuffling around your schedule and making it happen. I appreciate you. Definitely, you know, we're going to continue to, you know, to share the song on our end. It's on our Spotify playlist as well. We're going to be sharing it on our end as well, too. So definitely, you know, thank you. Enjoy the rest of your evening and the weekend ahead. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you. And thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it. This was fun.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Bye, guys.
Thank you, guys. Monk, thank you. Greg Monk, appreciate you buying a batch, brother. Appreciate you. Thank you to everyone that stuck it out with us. Hour and a half in. Y'all is still here. We appreciate y'all. This is the greatest. This is the end. This is the end. Kira, appreciate you coming on. Thank you, guys. Make sure you get the song, The Greatest. We get check out the music from everyone that we spoke to. We're going to be tagging them in the video. Y'all make sure you follow them. Go ahead, I'll just pause on this before IG try to block us. But, so we make sure you guys follow them, support independent artists, guys. They're out here. They're doing some great things. Appreciate you. How about my brother Darnell? I appreciate you, man. Fist bump, bro. Fist bump. You hung out for real, entire hour and a half for someone as busy as you and everyone else here. Appreciate you guys again. This is another episode of Buzzing in the Spotlight. Check out our Spotify playlist. Just search us on Spotify, Gospel Music Buzz. Check out our playlist that we have there. Check out the YouTube channel. We got a few amazing interviews already. In the can. Monday, we're going to be dropping our interview with Lecrae, talking about his role and journey to Bethlehem. And right after that, we have another surprise interview we're going to be dropping. So again, y'all follow us. Appreciate your support. Thank you guys for hanging out with us Friday evening. Take care, guys. Have a great one. Mm-hmm.